Hello and welcome to this very special episode of Tales and Trails. I'm Minnie Menon. It's a blistering hot day and I'm at one of the most famous archaeological sites in India today, Sanauli, where the excavations are still going on. They're wrapping it up soon. And this is where the famous chariots of Sanauli were found. This site dates back all the way to 2000 BCE, 4,000 years old, and the most amazing things have been found over here. There are few excavation sites in India that have got this kind of attention in recent times. The discovery of numerous burials with weapons and chariots in 2018 created a storm as the finds here in Sanauli, about 60 kilometers from Delhi, questioned a lot of the widely held beliefs in the subcontinent's history. Dated to anywhere between 2200 and 2000 BCE, excavations here over the last 2 years have unearthed evidence of a very advanced Chalcolithic culture where there was extensive use of copper. Contemporary to the Harappan civilization, evidence in Sanauli indicates the existence of an advanced parallel culture which had sword-wielding warriors and chariots. In this year's excavations, there has been fresh evidence of a large urban setup here and an iteration of the fact that women were powerful and probably fought alongside men.
It's a female skeleton, first of all. And we found a lot of antiquities associated with this burial. One of the most interesting thing with this skeleton is that the feet are missing. So probably they have cut the feet, tied the legs together and buried. An afterlife, a ritual, you know, they believe in afterlife, we don't know. Yes, it's very common and it's common in contemporary Chalcolithic sites in Deccan. For instance, in Anamgaon, we found a lot of skeletons with no feet. Another important antiquity that we have is the amulet around the arm. Amulet has, at present, has statite bead, agate bead and jasper. Along with this, we have a miniature antenna sword made of copper, which is right next to the head, probably placed on some sort of wooden object. That's the reason why the level is a little higher. This is the second female burial with similar miniature antenna sword in 2018's excavation, right just towards south of this burial in a row. We found another female skeleton with a similar antenna sword. And interestingly, towards north, there's another female burial. However, there's no antenna sword there. Here we have found antiquities such as copper pots, copper channel. We have evidences of bow and bone points associated with this burial within this burial pit, probably suggesting that women were also part of warrior class. They were also involved in these activities.
Excavations in Sanauli started in 2005 when local farmers discovered copper objects when sowing the field.
ये 2005 में हम अपनी मिट्टी उठा रहे थे यहाँ से खेत से तो फावड़े से उठाए तो यहाँ पे पोट मिलने शुरू हो गए बर्तन मैं कभी देखे थे जिनभी हमने देखे थे दिल्ली संग्रहालय में भी हम तो हमने ध्यान करा ये मिलते जुलते पोट है कहीं कामयाब पोट है ये तो हमने मीडिया को बुलवा उनके फोटो वगैरह खिंचवाए ट्रैक्टर ट्रोली पे मिट्टी पे तो फिर मीडिया ने जो है पेपर में आए तो न्यूज़ वगैरह में पढ़ के पुरातत्व विभाग की जो टीम थी वो यहाँ पे आई तो उन्होंने फिर 2005 में खुदाई की यहाँ पे
Since then, over 125 burials have been found here. This indicates that this was a large necropolis or burial site. Last year's big discovery was that of a chariot heavily inlaid with copper work. What made this truly interesting was what came with it. A yoke that showed it was probably a horse-drawn chariot and a helmet and shield. At the Institute of Archaeology in Delhi, the Sanauli excavation director explained why this is so important. In fact, an artist himself, Dr. Manjul, has even done a sketch based on what he found in Sanauli.
If you see, the size of the chariot is very, very important first. Second part, the pole and yoke of the chariot is also very, very important. If you see the size is smaller, like a war chariot, driven by one man or two, maximum two. And then pole is longer and having the thinner than the cart, and the yoke is very smaller. That indicates that it's possibly the horse chariot. Third one is the whip. We got the whip also with the chariot. That whip is like having the leather portion of leather strip. That type of whip is only used for the horse chariot. Helmet, it's possibly the oldest helmet of the world.
The area around Sinauli has been rich in archaeological sites. About 25 kilometers from the Ganga and 7.5 kilometers from the Yamuna, this region in the upper Ganga-Yamuna Doab was an important theater of activity 4,000 years ago. Manjul believes that the people in Sinauli were contemporaries of the Harappans, but they had their own strong identity.
This time we have done excavation in last year also, and we got in trial dig around 10 by 10 meter area, we got 8 burials of elite class. First, having the coffin and chariots and other thing. In this time also, we got 2 burial, coffin burial, highly decorated coffin burial, along with the burial goods like a copper mirror, antenna swords, etc., etc. And the other important thing, we also excavated the habitational site. Habitational site, we got 3 continuous superimposition of the floor level. And also the kiln and furnaces. In my opinion, in Indian context, we have the finest weapon of the world. Finest weapon of the world in contemporary period. If you see the copper hoard culture having the different type of weapons, not only the antenna, so advanced antenna sword in different size and shapes, but the ring and the anthropomorphic figure and dagger, and also you can see the shield in almost 8 shape, or you can see the torso shape shield. That's a popular in Egyptian and other culture also, that particular shapes. The technology of how we have identified the shield. First, we have identified with the CT scan. We have a CT scanned the whole chunk of the remains, and then we got the impression of wood in the below, and the top of the shield having the copper designing, etc., in the top, and also some socket for the handle of the shield. So that shows the very, very advanced level of shield also.
The people of Sinauli have been identified as part of the larger OCP culture. OCP, or ochre-colored pottery, was used by people around 2000 BCE along the Indo-Gangetic plain extending from eastern Punjab to northeastern Rajasthan and western Uttar Pradesh. In archaeological terms, this culture in the region was followed by the painted graveware culture that marked the coming of the Iron Age in the western Gangetic plain and the Ghaggar-Hakra Valley, lasting from roughly 1200 to 600 BCE. This painted graveware culture was famously linked to the Middle Vedic period by archaeologist B.B. Lal in the 1950s after he did an extensive study of sites like Hastinapur, Mathura, Ahichhatra, Barnava and Kurukshetra. All of these were mentioned in the epic Mahabharata. Based on this study and other research, the dates of when the battle that inspired the epic Mahabharata ensued remained a matter of debate, ranging from 1200 to 900 BCE. Dr. Manjul believes that the finds in Sinauli forces a rethink of these dates and assumptions.
Relating with the Mahabharata, particularly in the Sinauli and the surrounding area, it's a really eye-opening. Because the earlier discussion with the material culture and the Mahabharata the several hypotheses given by several scholars, particularly with the name Professor B.B. Lal, relating Mahabharata with the painted graveyard culture. The basis of that, that particular the villages mentioned in the Mahabharata and the Hastinapur having the earliest culture is painted graveyard. But in Hastinapur also, the OCP layer is there in the beneath the painted graveyard culture. And that particular area, almost every site, if you go to the Kurukshetra or in the Baghpat and other area which is mentioned in Mahabharata having OCP culture, either in the same mound or nearby. So the time gap of the PGW and OCP culture almost 700 or 800 years almost. So pushing back to the Mahabharata culture with the OCP, creating lot of new ideas to see the particularly relating with the material culture. If you see the nutshell in the Mahabharata having a story of warriors, the war, warfare, having the chariots, having the weapons. We have to understand the core of the story. The PGW culture, we don't have the urban nature of settlement anywhere of the PGW culture. The huts and the very little of weapons, only arrowheads and some of the iron object, but that is not a weapons in fact. It's a hunter-gatherer kind of culture is there in the PGW particularly, because we have done the excavation in Barnaba and the in the Rajasthan also the some of the PGW site. The whole PGW site settlement having the rural settlement, that's not a urban nature of the settlement.
What Dr. Manchul is saying is that based on the excavations in Sinauli and the area around the Upper Ganga Yamuna Doab, there is clear evidence of weaponry and warriors, indicating that this may have been the period of the Great War. The fact that there are no weapons that have been found along the painted graveyard culture iterates this. While many archaeologists and historians have associated this area with the battle, the date of the Mahabharata era was always thought to be of a much later period. But now that is being questioned. Were these warriors buried here in Sanauli contemporaries of the heroes who inspired the epic Mahabharata? The discovery in Sanauli has been significant, but a lot more studies need to be conducted here in Sanauli and across the region strewn with archaeological sites still to be discovered. The rich soils of the Ganga Yamuna Doab have been among the oldest inhabited areas of the Indian subcontinent. And even today, life continues here, with farmers ploughing the soil as they have done for thousands of years. But what secrets lie under this ground remains to be seen.